topic is applications of integration. The first thing here we'll be studying is how to find total revenue function and the demand function when marginal revenue function is given. Now, suppose that R is the total revenue function and X is the output. And suppose marginal revenue function given, and we know that marginal revenue is nothing but change in revenue with respect to X. Now from marginal revenue we have to find total revenue. Now suppose we are taking integration on both the sides, integral will cancel this derivative. So total revenue is nothing but integral of marginal revenue with respect to output, that is with respect to X. Now suppose we have total revenue, and total revenue is nothing but price into output. So we can find demand function, that is P, using R by X. Okay, so let's look at this example. So we have to find total revenue function and the demand function if the marginal revenue function is given as 4 minus 2x minus 3x squared. So this is the function given, and using this marginal revenue we have to find revenue, total revenue, as well as demand function. So given is marginal revenue, that is 4 minus 2 times x minus 3x squared. Okay, we know that revenue is nothing but integral of marginal revenue with respect to x. So this is integral of 4 minus 2x minus 3x squared with respect to x. Now integral of 4, so 4 as it is, and integral of 1 is x. So it is 4x minus 2 times integral of x is x square by 2 minus 3 times integral of x square is x cube by 3 plus constant. So this 2 will get cancelled, this 3 will get cancelled. So total revenue function is 4x minus x square minus x cube plus c. Now we have to find the value of c. We know that if output is going to be 0, what will be our revenue? Revenue will also going to be 0. If we are not producing anything at all, we are not going to have any income, so revenue will be 0. So using this condition we have to find value of C. So I am writing it here. Now R is 0, we are substituting X to be 0 here, so 4 into 0 minus 0 square minus 0 cube plus C. So what is C? C also is 0 in this case. So what will be total revenue now? Total revenue is 4x minus x square minus x cube plus 0. So we can write this as 4x minus x square minus x cube. So we got our revenue function. Now using this total revenue we have to find demand function. And what is demand function? Demand function is revenue by x. So this 4x minus x square minus x cube divided by x. Now from here we can take x common. So if I am taking x common, remaining is 4 minus, from x square I am taking x out, so remaining will be only 1x, and from 3x I am taking 1x out, so remaining is x square, and this is divided by x. So we can cancel this. So demand function in this case is 4 minus x minus x square. So given marginal revenue we can find revenue function, and using revenue function we can find demand function. Now next is we have to find cost function when the marginal cost is given. So we know that marginal cost is again change in cost with respect to change in quantity or change in output. So what will be the cost? It is integral of marginal cost with respect to change in output. Now it's same as revenue. Marginal revenue is change in revenue, marginal cost is change in cost. So cost will be integral of marginal cost. So this, if we are taking integral on both the side, this side integral will be cancelled using by this derivative. Okay, so what will remain is cost equals to integral of marginal cost. Now let's look at this example. We have to find the cost function and the average cost if the marginal cost is given as 3x square minus 2x plus 7 if the fixed cost is 200. Okay, and the fixed cost is given as 200. Now, before finding cost function, okay. Now, what is cost actually? Cost consists of variable cost plus fixed cost. So, this variable cost is are those functions which will be or are those quantities which is going to have variables with it. Like for example, suppose we have some function 3x square minus 2x plus 7. Okay, even though this is marginal cost, let me take some other example. Okay, now in this case, these three quantities have x with it and this one quantity there is no x. So, this is variable cost and this is fixed cost. Now, no matter what is going to be your value of output, this fixed cost is never going to be changed. Wherein, this variable cost, these three terms are going to vary with respect to change in output. So, always cost function will consist of variable cost plus fixed cost. And fixed cost is that value wherein we have which is not going to change, and variable cost are those quantities wherein we are going to have some x values, and whenever this output will change, this variable cost is also going to change. Okay, so this was just an example. Okay, so let's solve this question. What is marginal cost given? Marginal cost is given as 3x square minus 2x plus 7. Okay, now we have to find cost function. And what is cost function? Cost function is integral of marginal cost with respect to x. So, integral of 3x square minus 2x plus 7 with respect to x. So, 3 is a constant, we have to integrate x square with respect to x. Minus 2 is a constant, we have to integrate x. Plus 7 is a constant, so we have to integrate basically 1. Or this 1 can be written as x raised to power 0. Okay, so 3, n is 2, so it will be 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 minus x 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 plus 7 times 0 plus 1 by 0 plus 1 plus constant. Okay, so this can be written as 3 times x cube by 3 minus 2 times x square by 2 plus 7 times x plus constant. This 3 will get cancelled, this 2 will get cancelled. So, what is our cost function? Cost function is x cube minus x square plus 7x plus c. Now, this 3 quantity is nothing but variable cost and we have a fixed cost. And what is fixed cost given? Now, since this c is a constant, okay, this is going to be a fixed cost. Now, what is fixed cost given? Fixed cost given is 200. So, we can write this cost function as x cube minus x square plus 7x plus 200. So, this is our required cost function. So, we got cost function. Next is we have to find average cost. Now, what is average cost? Average cost is cost by total output, right? So, total cost by total output. So, what is total cost? X cube minus x square plus 7x plus 200 divided by x. So, we can write this as x cube by x minus x square by x plus 7x by x plus 200 by x. So, this will get cancelled. 1 will get cancelled. Remaining is 2 in this case. So, we can write average cost as x square minus x plus 7 plus 200 by x. So, this is average cost. So, given a marginal cost, we can find cost function as well as average cost. Next example, if the marginal revenue for a commodity when the demand D is 20 minus 2D, find the total revenue when the demand D is given as 4. So, what is given? Marginal revenue is given when demand is D. So, marginal revenue is given as 20 minus 2 times D. and we have to find total revenue when demand D is given as 4. So we have to find total revenue when demand is given as 4. Okay, let's first find total revenue function. And total revenue function is nothing but integral of marginal revenue with respect to x. So it is integral of 20 minus 2 times d with respect to, in this case output is given as, or demand is given as d, so this will be with respect to d. Okay, so 20 is a constant, so we can write this as 20 into integral of d raised to power 0 minus 2 times integral of d with respect to d, this is also with respect to d. So 20 d raised to power 0, so d raised to power 0 plus 1 by 0 plus 1 minus 2 times 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 plus constant. So we can write this as 20 into d by 1 minus 2 times d square by 2, so this 2 will get cancelled plus c. So revenue function in this case is 20d minus d square plus c. So we got revenue function, but we have to find revenue function when demand is given as 4. Okay, let me write it here. So revenue function we got here 20d minus d square plus c. Okay, but still we have this constant, right? And we know that if demand is 0, okay, if demand is 0, if there is no demand, we are not going to produce anything. So what will be our revenue? Revenue is also going to be 0. So if revenue is 0, this will be 20 into 0 minus 0 square plus c. So what is value of c? C is also 0. If revenue is 0, this will be 0, 20 into 0 minus 0 plus c, so c is 0. So we can write our revenue function as 20d minus d square. So we got our revenue function. Now we have to find revenue when demand is given as 4. So this will be 20, wherever there is d, we have to substitute 4 instead of d. So this is 20 into 4 minus 4 square. So 20 into 4, 80 minus 16, which is equals to, so this is nothing but 64. So revenue when demand is 4 is nothing but 64. So this is our revenue function, and if demand is specifically given, that is in this case demand is given as 4, so revenue when demand is 4 is 64.